Scribe David Thompson, director choreographer Susan Stroman, and composer John Kander have joined forces on the new musical, The Beast in the Jungle, which is scheduled to begin performances at the Vineyard Theatre on May 4th. The production stars Tony nominees Peter Friedman and Tony Yazbek as John Marcher at different ages. The character's life is haunted by the constant worry that his life is to be doomed by a catastrophic happening, a beast in the jungle. We headed to New 42nd Street Studios to get the scoop on this new work.
It is a story by Henry James. He wrote a novella called The Beast in the Jungle, and it's about this man named John Marcher, who sort of goes through his entire life afraid of what love can do to him and the commitment that love could possibly have an effect on him. And so what happens is he becomes haunted by this beast that physically, emotionally, mentally is attacking him. Now, whether or not that is real or not, we find out in the play. But he believes that he is completely conquered if he gets too close to real love.
I love what Tommy Thompson has done with the original Henry James novella. He's done a fabulous adaptation. And having done one workshop, seeing the work that Susan Stroman has done to make it all live is very exciting. You know, and of course, to be here with John Kander is incredible.
This show talks about fear in the sense of some people have something that have happened to them in their lifetime that keeps them from moving forward. Somehow this event grips them like a beast, and it keeps them from living their life.
Thompson, Stroman, and Kander are the all-star creative team behind the Tony-nominated musical The Scottsboro Boys, which also got its start at the Vineyard. They spoke about their longtime collaboration.
This will be my fourth show at the Vineyard. I did Floor of the Red Menace and The Scottsboro Boys and the play Dot. So The Beast in the Jungle will be my fourth show there. But also the collaboration of John Kander and David Thompson and myself, we have a great collaboration, and it's a joy to work with one another and feed off of one another. And the Vineyard is like a home for us. I know Kander's done a couple shows there too, and it's just like a place to create, and it feels very fulfilling to be at the Vineyard.
Stro and I started our careers with Kander and Fred Ebb doing Floor of the Red Menace in 1988. At the Vineyard as a revival. I rewrote the book and Stroh choreographed it, and Scott Ellis actually had directed it. But it was an opportunity for us to start a collaboration that 30 years ago, I can't imagine a day going by without it.
Well, the Vineyard is our home, really, but certainly mine. And it all happened actually during the party after Scottsboro Boys opened. And I very drunkenly asked, can I live here? And they very drunkenly said, sure.